This trial in the Roger Clemens perjury case had barely gotten underway today. This was the second day of evidence, and the judge declared a mistrial. He was very angry at prosecutors because they introduced some evidence in this case that he had ruled out of bounds. They showed jurors that Andy Pettit, a former teammate of Roger Clemens, had told his wife that he and Mr. Clemens had a conversation about human growth hormone. The judge had said that evidence shouldn't be in this case because Laura Pettit never directly talked to Roger Clemens and it was hearsay. But still, prosecutors did allow information about Laura Pettit's statement to get in before the jurors. The judge was very angry. He told the prosecutors that a first-year law student would have known to get this out of the evidence. He said that he had been upset because they wasted taxpayer money, several days here of jury selection, and he felt like that the genie was out of the bottle and you couldn't unring the bell and give Roger Clemens a fair trial. He said that Roger Clemens would face jail time if he was convicted, and so he needed to have this case end in a mistrial. The judge said he would take under consideration Clemens' motion to avoid having a second trial. He's going to have both sides come back to this courthouse on September 2nd to have a hearing on whether or not there will be a second trial. There is a very mixed record in terms of these steroid prosecutions or steroid-related prosecutions. You've had three players, Barry Bonds, who was not convicted on his main charge, Miguel Tejada, he pled guilty to a misdemeanor and was convicted in that case, but he didn't serve any sort of jail time. And now you have this mistrial in the Clemens case. This is a huge black eye for the Justice Department and a big misstep for the prosecution.